Well, it's been a few weeks. Welcome to another episode of Doing Stuff with Aaron. Today is a little different. We're in a provincial campground, surrounded by people. I don't know how this is gonna work. Anyways, we're just back in here somewhere. Whatever. Paid $35. We're in Golden Ears Park at a place called Gold Creek. Maybe we'll take a little hike and go check out that creek today. It's around 1 o'clock. Not allowed to check in till 1. Anyways, I'm rocking the ponytail today. Got a passenger with me, and one of my other vehicles is making an appearance here. It's the Blue Dragon. Blue Dragon. Rawr. He helps you get around. Anyways, we're gonna load up BD there and head over to our campsite. Set up for the afternoon, sit down, relax. We've got some steak. Bunch of other things. No campfires, campfire ban. It's like 800 degrees or something like that. There's a fire, a trail fire we have to walk through here. So, something I have to pee. Anyways, welcome to a half bald edition of Doing Stuff with Aaron. Let's do it. Sometimes hiking to your campsite's the hardest part. F6. F4. Ah. Sounds of running water tonight, that's good. F5. F7, F8. Store food in there, I'll just use my car. F6. Home sweet home. Definitely have people there, there, and there. We got people down there. And people there. So it's a fire pit and a table. Blue Dragon did a great job. Okay. Wow, look at the glow. Let's get set up. Okay. Okay, here's our site for the night. Blue dragon came in crucial. There's the tent set up, my chair, brought a little barbecue with me, and my little stove. Right now it's nice and quiet. Everybody's down. I don't know if you can see in the distance here, but there's a lake. There's a lake down there. So maybe we'll wander down, but I'm hungry. I think I'm gonna cook. What time is it? It is 1:46. I'll set up my sleeping bag later tonight. Set up. I think this is episode 22 or something like that. I took a few weeks off. My daughter graduated elementary school and my son turned 11. 11. So I decided just, you know, chill with the family there for a few days. But not this week. God, I had to get away from them this week. So here I am remembering how much I hate camping in provincial campgrounds. The water source won't stop running, and it's not a river, it's a tap. So yeah, that's gonna drive me nuts. Big family of kids, I could tell. Big family of kids. Big family of kids. And how much do you want to bet this is gonna be kids too? So already screaming and crying behind me, but it's okay, we're gonna make the best of it. I think we're gonna do a shout out to Steve Wallis there. I don't know if you watch Steve Wallis. This is step two once you get camp set up. Crack of step two. We're having a Bacardi rum punch, and I got here an hour early, so might have had one while I was waiting. Anyways, talk to you soon. It's actually really nice here right now. There's nobody around, so I'm just gonna chill at the campsite, and then when everybody shows up will be my time to go for a walk. It's pretty late for me. I've been up since 12 o'clock, so like a.m. So 2 o'clock in the afternoon right now. Definitely dinner time for me. I'm super happy and relaxed to be outside. These trees are fantastic. Check out these trees, man.
I'm just sitting here staring up, enjoying the weather. It's probably like 23 degrees Celsius or so. We've got so much space. And they jam everybody into these little spots here. Man, I drove 12 kilometers through the trees to get to this spot. You think they would use up 6 of those kilometers and build another 200-300 sites, man. So silly. And then they're like, you need a day pass to come in here because there's too many people who want to use the parks. But they haven't spent any freaking money on the parks in forever. So, like, you couldn't even check in. They said they had to clean the sites. You couldn't check in till 1, but when you get here, there's garbage and stuff. Anyways, that's enough bitching from me. The rum punch is pretty good, actually. I think I'm gonna pack this back and do a little bit of reading on my phone and fire up the barbecue here pretty soon. A different episode. I hope you enjoy it. We're gonna get back to the hiking pretty soon. Okay. We're crocked out. And I took my work shorts off. Hey! Cheers. I'm camping. If you can call it that. It'll do.
One big benefit is washrooms.
Okay. Freshly back from a pee break. I did a little bit of exploring and I saw a cool place we might check out here shortly, but I don't think we're allowed to have briquettes. But there's nobody around, so let's just do this. Come on, baby. Easy light my ass. Super windy out right now. Well, not super windy, but it's windy. Anyways, I'll get back to you shortly. Okay, I finally got the barbecue lit. I should stop being such a cheap ass and just buy a propane barbecue. But I had to use my little portable stove and I just kind of bent it over and ran it into the coals. But I melted it. I probably got pretty close to exploding. Anyways, we'll have some steaks here pretty soon. Okay, I found a handy stick. I think I'm gonna knock this down and start grilling some steaks. Okay, let's see what steak number one is like. I'm gonna call that done. You know I love my Napoleon Dynamite steaks. Into this bad boy and see what it's like. Salt and pepper. Oh wow, it's actually really good.
It doesn't look very good, but it is good.
Stew number two. Okay, dinner's done. There's people everywhere. One thing I like to do when I'm in the provincial campground is walk to the concession stand and get candy. So let's go for a walk. Okay. I got an ice cream cone, a Slurpee, a Twix, an arrow, and peanuts. There were so many kids there. I haven't done this since I was a wee youngster. This is a really good Slurpee. It's the best one I've had in a long time. Hey, this kind of looks like a trail. Let's see where this goes. This is a nice spot I found. I'm probably about 100 feet up on the campsite. It's all around this big hill here. And there's lots of beaten down trails, so it looks like the kids scramble a lot up on this hill and people hike or something like that. Get my fix of solitude before I head back into the hillside of families sleeping in tents. There's no bugs, so that's pretty sweet. Talkative video, so maybe just kind of enjoy the sights and we'll go explore the lake in a little bit here too. Thanks for watching so far. Thank you.
that's good. Super hot though.
Well, last two pieces of bacon. Hot. Okay, I got my chair, I'm all packed up in the car, and what I wanted to do last night before I passed out, I literally went in my tent to set up my sleeping bag, and I laid down for 2 minutes and I was gone. I woke up at 3 a.m. So decent, went back to sleep, had a good 12-hour sleep, which was nice. But I'm gonna get down there to the water here this morning and just take an hour before I head home. Hey, puppy. Look at wildlife. There he is. Anyways, I think I saw a path. I think I saw a path here the other day, yesterday. Is this it? I think this is it. Yeah, I'm pretty sure this is it. This part's a bit steep. Maybe I'll put the camera away for this part. Got down to the bottom here. Not too shabby, eh? I think I'm gonna walk over right over there, sit in the shade. Here they are in the morning. That guy fired up that machine at 7 o'clock in the morning, man. And he woke up the whole campsite. Good view for having a jet ski, buddy. Oh, we're just gonna chill here for a little bit. So this guy's jet ski pulls into a jet boat, which he's towing behind his actual boat. Anyways. It's a low-key episode of doing stuff with Aaron. Time to go home.